All right, let me research my next video. I just watched a video from Nick Nimmin here, which is really interesting because it's about productivity on YouTube. And I thought I could do a similar video. Let me show you a research process today that is based on a video that you watched from a similar channel. So here's already my first tip of the YouTube SEO tips that you have in this video today, which is if you are watching a video from a similar channel, Nick Nimmin certainly is a similar channel than mine, right? We have similar audiences, and that video of that other channel is successful for his audience, which it obviously was, then there's a good chance that it will work on your channel as well. So that's the idea. I take this video here, click on the share button, copy the link to the video, and go into the keyword research tool and paste it here. By the way, if you are using a different keyword research tool, you will shortly get the idea how to use other tools in a similar manner to do the same research process. But if you are interested, there's a link in the description to check out Morningfame's keyword research tool. All right, so back to the starting point. So we have decided this video here shall be the basis for our research. I want to do a similar video. So what it starts now here, and that it's the basis of this kind of research process, we start with the tags of those videos. First of all, the tags of the video that I just watched and I want to do a similar video of, and also about the tags that similar videos, not only the one, but alongside other similar videos as well. This is the basis for our inspiration to get the search term that we want to optimize our video for then in the end. All right, let me look through those tags. I'm certainly not a large channel yet. So these tags here, which are usually used by those big channels, are too competitive for me to rank. By the way, competition is key. Only if the competition is low enough, then you have a good chance to rank. So we have to find a search term that has low enough competition for your channel size. And since I'm not a large channel, those video tags here. Let me quickly check this. Oh, I didn't expect that actually. So in this particular case, common mistakes YouTubers make does give me quite good grades here. So the competition grades here are not perfect, but it's interesting to have a look at it. So let's go over, look into the details. And the interesting part now, when we scroll down here, Morningfame identifies the gateway video. And that is basically the idea. There is always one video in the search result for this particular search term, which has very low numbers. So if that channel succeeded in ranking its video there, well, then if you have at least as good numbers as that channel, then you have a good chance to rank there as well. So we particularly look at the gateway video, and you remember the competition was a little bit too high. So the idea would be to look at the tags from this video, because obviously the SEO of this video here managed to rank well in YouTube search, so we can get inspiration from that. So I look through those tags of these videos. And by the way, I didn't mention, like also before, we are looking at video tags from other creators here, right? So we have to be careful because there are two types of tags. One type is tags that contain search terms that actually viewers type into the search bar and find videos based on that. So real search terms. And other tags might contain just any phrase that actually no other viewers are searching. And if you would rank for such invented terms, then no one would come by and find your video via this search term, because it's no search term. So we have to be careful. We have to filter those tags, whether they are real search terms that many viewers actually do search on YouTube search, so that we, of course, get viewers coming along and watch our video. So that is done here, by the way, with the red X. That means most likely this is an invented term. Can you imagine that someone types into the search bar 7 tips for new YouTubers with brackets, mistakes to avoid fast? That is not a search term that people are using. So I'm ignoring these and only looking at these with a green check. Get noticed on YouTube. That certainly is a term that someone would type into the search bar. But unfortunately, it's a little bit too competitive for me. I wouldn't have a good chance to rank there. So let's move on. What do we have here? Mistakes YouTubers make. All right, not too bad, but my subscriber count here is not good enough. Everyone who knows the Morningfame keyword research tool learns to know how the grades work. By the way, what we are looking here for are at least yellow grades. Red grades are not good. They indicate that the competition is too high. All right, as you see here, of course, this is all evolving around common mistakes YouTubers make and related search terms. I originally intended to do a video about YouTube productivity, right? So let's go back, but of course, do your research in that way. Browse the different tags that YouTubers use, because you might find a different topic that you originally didn't intend to do a video about, but it might be a really good opportunity for you to rank for that. So you might decide, after all, to do a video about, in this case, common mistakes YouTubers make, because of course you're flexible. Whatever is good for your audience, make a video about it. And here, yeah, use the opportunity if you discover something. But let's go back here. In the original keyword tab, we can look now through the smaller channels tags that are usually less competitive. And again, we look at those with a green check because these are real search terms. Let's quickly look that up. All right, that doesn't look too bad. An E grade is not perfect, but let's move forward. Best advice for new YouTubers. How about that? All right, too competitive. Maybe a little more here. Mistakes small YouTubers make. Oh, see that? That is a search term that has low enough competition. You see here DDDA grades. It is a common search term, has pretty good search volume. This overall looks really good. So let's go to step three. We have this search term locked in. And now with this search term, which is good, which is something that I could do a video about. Again, it's not about YouTube productivity as I intended in the beginning, but that's the process. It really is about how you browse the possible search terms you could optimize a video for, and then choose those that are a good opportunity for you, where you can successfully rank with a good chance and is a topic that works well for your audience. And this would be a perfect example. So go ahead. And by the way, all of you who are already using the Morningfame keyword research tool, I don't have to show you the rest anymore. You know it too well. So in that case, check out this video because it shows you many more techniques how you could browse the different search terms. And every one of you who is new to SEO, let me show you the last step where you actually do optimize your video. So here we have chosen our target search term where we primarily want to rank, and then we go into the last step where we create the metadata for our video. So the title, description, tags, as well as the thumbnail. And what we want to achieve here, we want to have highly optimized metadata, which has high relevance for our target search term here. So the idea is that we first rank our video for this target search term, mistakes small YouTubers make in this case, and then YouTube automatically will understand the topic of your video and also will rank your video for related search terms. So you focus on one search term, but that doesn't mean you only rank for that single search term, but also you will rank for related search terms. And how you make it happen is you put this search term into the title. The keyword research tool already automatically populated this title. This is good for now for SEO. You might add something interesting in the end. For example, what I learned from hundreds of YouTubers. Something intriguing, for example, that is always a good idea because you want to win the click from those people instead that people who search the search term click another video, right? yours should be clicked. So an intriguing title like this, but also with a search term in there so you have a good chance to rank. Then you do a description. I learned these mistakes small YouTubers make, and you see the relevance just went up because I have now the target search term in the description as well. And then from hundreds of YouTubers. Don't make these mistakes as well. Basically explaining why you can shortcut the learnings from other YouTubers, right? So that would make sense for a description. And then finally, we have the tags. Morningfame already provided quite a few. Those with the red X are again invented tags, which we don't really need. So we remove every tag that doesn't have a green check. And with that, actually, it already looks quite good. All right, we have the tags. And now finally, we can also upload our thumbnail there, because now, since we know where we want our video to rank, we also know which other videos are ranking there. And here you see the top 5 spots, which are the videos that are ranking for our target search term. And now the idea is to design a thumbnail that is more intriguing than those competing thumbnails. So again, here you're trying to win the click instead of letting people click another video that appears in the search results as well. And it's a good idea to compare your thumbnails with those competing thumbnails so you ensure that yours stands out and people tend to click on yours rather than the others. That is the full keyword research process, which allows you to rank really well. And if you are interested, this was kind of a special style of research because we based it on a video in the beginning. You usually intend to do your research with starting with a search term, right? You have a video topic in mind and you can already imagine what kind of search term people would be typing into the search bar in order to later find your video once you have published it. So if you're interested in a kind of different, more standard way of doing keyword research, doing YouTube SEO, well then check out this video, which is really interesting to watch. Cheers, my friends.